Welcome back to our preview of the 2014 Barrett-Jackson Scottsdale Collector Car Auction, coming to you here on the Fox family of networks come January. Every year, Barrett-Jackson offers the very best in Corvettes. And who better to buy one from than a family with a rich ownership history of many celebrated Corvettes? Lance Miller, a second-generation collector, learned Corvettes from his father, Chip, the founder of the famed Corvettes at Carlisle event in Pennsylvania. Well, Lance and the Miller family have consigned three very special vets from their collection to Scottsdale. Two of them will cross the Barrett-Jackson block together. Then, there's the 1963 Stingray, customized by legendary George Barris. It's known as Asteroid.
Now, if you're a fan of rock and roll as it pertains to hot rods, you may recognize Asteroid from a vintage Jan and Dean album way back when. Right now, let's meet the Pennsylvania-based Miller family and learn exactly why Corvettes are so close to their hearts.
I grew up around Corvettes, and truly, it all began in 1972 when I was born. My dad had purchased a 1953 Corvette, and essentially that's what got him started. I'm Lance Miller, I'm from Carlisle, Pennsylvania, and I'm selling three Corvettes at Barrett-Jackson. He was very passionate about the brand itself. Essentially, it was kind of the cream of the crop, so to speak. And he just went after them. And to be honest, as he collected the cars, it just essentially became more and more of a passion to the point that they became like children to him. The most famous race car my father ever purchased was a 1960 Le Mans Corvette that was driven by John Fitch and Bob Grossman. Absolutely hands down, this car was the pinnacle to his collection and still is today.
His dream was, and he said to John Fitch right away, we're taking this car to Le Mans in 2010. And John Fitch said right away, I'm going. Count me in, I'm going.
My father passed away in 2004, and unfortunately his dream was cut short. So I took it to heart, and I decided to take the car back to Le Mans. And sure enough, we did just that.
It was really something we had to do because it meant so much to him to have that car there. So it was our way of fulfilling his dream.
Life is good.
And now let's have a closer look at the car that will be sold to raise funds for the Chip Miller Foundation. It's a 1969 Chevy Corvette Coupe.
We were fortunate. Barrett-Jackson had helped us out through the years.
Now, I don't know how many of you have met Chip Miller, but I had that privilege. He started these wonderful events at Carlisle, and a real loss to humanity and to our hobby.
When my dad passed away from amyloidosis, we started the Chip Miller Charitable Foundation, and we've taken a couple cars through auction.
$31,000. Thank you, Joe. God bless you.
You know, this year, a lot of great Corvettes are going to be there. And decided, you know what, it's a great venue to push these incredible cars that we have. The neat thing about our 53 Corvette is it's truly an original car. It's VIN number 181 out of 300 cars. The miles very low. It's at 9,260 miles. Just amazing. It was in the center of the build of the cars. And these cars were very archaic. I mean, when they put these cars together, they were truly built by hand, and you can see just that. In 2002, Chevrolet came out with the 50th anniversary Corvette. It's neat to have VIN number 181 on both sides 50 years later. And his goal was to achieve matching miles on the car, so we recently did that as well. You go from a 53 Corvette that's all original to 63 Corvette now that is like, I mean, over the top. You have three different people that are a part of that car. Obviously, somebody that built the interior of the car, Don Ferreira. Then you have the exterior of the car, done by George Barris. Then you have the brains behind it, Northcott. So truly, it's an amazing, amazing vehicle in so many different aspects. Bob Nordskog was a big time racer. He loved speed. He loved boat racing. He loved car racing. He just wanted to enjoy the adrenaline rush that you get when you bang through gears, whether it's a boat or in a car. And truly, that's what he did to the asteroid. The car originally came out as a paint delete car, which is incredibly rare. You're gonna see a long extended nose that goes out. Again, it relates to the boat side of Nordskog. The asteroid, they always said it had a split personality, and simply because of the fact, he wanted to take the car to various car events, Motoramas, and then he wanted to take it to the drag strip. And a lot of times when he showed it at, like, the Motorama itself, the car would be on like a turntable, and one half of the car would be race mode, the other half street mode. So that's the way we have the car today. It's exactly as it was. Without a doubt, my dad's there. When I took that 1960 Le Mans car around the track with John Fitch, he was in the car. The same thing's gonna go for the 53 when it goes over the block. I guarantee you I'm gonna feel his presence.
I think he watches out for us. He knows.
It's just one of those things that the car is always going to be dubbed Chip Miller's car.
After the break, award-winning American Muscle.
It was recently judged this year at the GTO convention, received gold honors.
And a championship-winning drag racer.
This car was one of the pinnacle Z28s of all time. It actually put the Z28 on the map.
And later on, one-of-a-kind horsepower that will inspire you to grab the brass ring.
It's an historical piece of a collector's dream.